Hi, Carrie here from My Quick Bookkeeping. One of the most common errors I see when I'm helping clients to clean up their books is that they're adding transactions that have come in from the bank feed instead of matching them to things that have already been recorded in QuickBooks. You can end up with transactions entered twice, your expenses are overstated, your taxes are wrong, your bank won't reconcile, and if it's a payment from a customer that's come in, you might not be able to tell if they've paid or if it's a deposit. So it's really important that you understand how to do the matching from the bank feed. We're going to walk through that today. Today we're in the Canadian sample company. You'll open up to your dashboard and you see your bank accounts here. Now let's have a look at the checking account. It says there are 12 transactions to review. So we'll click through here. We can see the bank feed has brought in these transactions and we need to now either add them, match them, or do something with them to get them into our QuickBooks. Just as a note here, these items that show up for review are not actually in QuickBooks yet. That's something that I think is a little bit confusing. So if you're looking at the for review tab, none of these things have been entered from the bank feed. Now here's where people often trip up. They see all of these things, they're like, okay, IT support center, I remember this, what this was, they'll pop in. They'll add it to their expenses. Let's see, where would this one likely go? Professional fees. They add it and off they go. Oh, better put in a tax code. We're in Ontario, so we'll do yes. They add it and it's now in QuickBooks. So if we look at the In QuickBooks tab here, this item has been added. And if we looked at our reports, this expense would be in here. Now that's fine if we hadn't already entered the expense. So let's go and check and see if it's already been entered. Pop over to the expenses tab here on the left. And we'll choose suppliers. And we'll look for this IT guy. Here it is, IT Support Center. Now if we have a look, we already have a transaction in here for $100.01. So that would explain why it wasn't matched on our bank feed. And now it looks like we've recorded this twice. Here we are in the profit and loss. Let's scroll down and have a look under professional fees. We have $177 in here. We'll open it up. And here we have the two amounts, one of them that we'd already entered and one we entered from the bank feed. So we've doubled up on our expenses. So we're going to pop back here now. I'm going to go back to the bank feed and go to In QuickBooks. And we're going to undo this add that we did because we don't want to add that. We know we've already got it. So we have it here and we're going to, where is it? Here it is. Oh, look at this. It knows what to do with it now, but once again, we don't want to add it. So let's have a look and we're going to say find match. And it hasn't come up with the match. This is because the amount is different. So we're going to close out of this and pop back to that original transaction that we must have entered. So if we go to expenses, back into the IT support company, here we have our 101. Now what's most likely happened is when it's calculated the tax, the HST, it's gone and made it different by 1 cent. So I'm going to change this now to 1150. Save and close. Pop back to our bank feed. Let's see if it's been able to match. Look at that. One record found and we can match. So now we match it. We'll go back to our profit and loss again. Let's just rerun that, all dates in here. We have professional fees of $88.50 and we've only included it once. Now when we then of course go to do our bank reconciliation, it will work too because we have the expense in once, not twice, and our income statement is also correct. Does that make sense? Hopefully that does. If not, reach out, let me know, and just be super careful when you're working with this bank feed. Because if you add things that are already in, you're going to end up doubled up. Perhaps another day I'll walk through these deposits and matching them to customer payments. If that's something that's of interest to you, do let me know. If you're in this situation and would like some help to get it sorted out, reach out. You can book a consultation with me. There's a link to my website below. I can help you out from anywhere with all of these wonderful remote tools we have now. If this video is useful, please click like below, subscribe to my channel. I can help you out with all sorts of QuickBooks tips and how-tos. I've created a small business month-end checklist. Now, if you were following through this and doing your reconciliation at the end of every month, you probably wouldn't have the situation that I hope you're not in, but if you watch this video, you probably are. So download that below. You'll be subscribed to my newsletter as well, which will let you know if there's anything else that could help you. If there's something else you'd like to know about, please make a comment, send me an email, and I'd love to make my next video for you. Cheers.